Now, the Searle brothers were also gold medalists in Barcelona. Here, they've changed events. They're part of the Coxless Fours team. Again, semi-final.
This is approaching halfway now. 1,000 metres, second semi-final of the men's Coxless Fours. Great Britain comfortably in second place from Romania.
Yeah, and that's good rowing for Britain. Britain has eased up from a length down to half a length. They're now in an attacking position.
Slovenia were in third place behind Romania and Great Britain, with Poland fourth. Germany and the United States in the two outside lanes have had an extra race here, having come through the repechage.
They've quickened the pace a bit more now. Lovely stroking from Tim Foster, very natural stroke. Sets up the time for Greg Searle, who's the great workhorse. Tremendous power he's able to unleash in the final stages of the race. But I think there's going to be a real scrap behind for third place, so there's going to be pressure all the time from the middle and back of the pack. But I think it's Britain who are pulling up now. They're almost level. You can see the sterns of the two boats, and Britain just edging up on Romania.
And if Britain can maintain this and dictate from the front and see others dropping back behind them, they might have a rather easier semi-final than the Italians have just had, the world champions. It was world champions against Olympic champions in the first semi-final, both qualified.
And so I'm not sure they're quite at their best. They've been very dominant for the last 2 years, the Italians, but I think that they may lose their title, as it were, when they come to the Saturday. But Britain, I think, now perhaps has the edge. We're going away from the Romanians.
Once again, the third 500 metres of the race proving important. Great Britain have gone through now in first place ahead of Romania. Slovenia are in third place, the Poles still in fourth. We're looking at the Americans, who are not going to figure.
Yes, the Poles could get back in. They were bronze medalists, so one change, bronze medalists from last year. But it's Britain now with what looks like more than half a length.
And looking comfortable. Got about 350 metres to go. Great Britain leading the early pacemakers from Romania. Deep at Hobolt, sir. Johnny Searle, Greg Searle, Tim Foster.
Well in control. Rates is really very comfortable. Johnny, who's the sort of command post here, was having a good look, making sure everything was under control. They'll have to quicken a little bit as they come towards the end, but it's now up to 40. But they're in command. Everyone's got to make for them.
So Great Britain now beginning to lengthen. They were third at the World Championships 2 years ago, silver medalist and only narrowly silver medalist last year, and they are hungry for gold here in Georgia. Camera angle there is just a little deceptive. Great Britain are comfortable enough. Great Britain coming up towards the line now. Great Britain followed by Romania. And Great Britain are over the line first, Romania second, Slovenia third, and that is another very encouraging performance for Great Britain.
We didn't really come here to win the semi-final, we came to win the final, and that's what we've now put ourselves in a position that we're ready to try and do that, and we've just done a job really to get there, and that's what we're going to try and do now.
I think often in a race like that, where although it looks like there's a few obvious crews that are going to go through, that just means that the crews that are less fancied really fly off the start, because they know they've got to get up and getting involved. So I thought we went reasonably well for the first 500, and I think we expected people like the Americans, the Germans, to throw everything in early in the hope that they could produce a storming row and pick up that third place qualifying slot.
Semi-finals are pretty difficult things, because with only three boats to qualify, the person in fourth is always going to be flying, and so everyone's going to try and get up and go for that position. I think we've got the pressure on ourselves, really, and we've always had the pressure on ourselves. And other people might see Steve and Matthew, and they might see us. But I don't think it'll particularly affect us, really, because we put so much on ourselves anyway, that the expectation of other people, it's nice if they're interested, but it's not going to affect us particularly one way or the other.
I think at the end of the day, we're going to be a lot more disappointed than anyone else if we don't do our thing here.